Hello and welcome to Maxable, your number one resource for ADU information. This is the third video in our series giving you a step-by-step guide to building your ADU. In this video, we will cover all the details about framing your ADU. You can also check out our other videos or maxablespace.com for all the resources you need to build the ADU of your dreams. So let's dive in. All right, let's start by taking a look at the original plans here. You can see the dark shaded gray lines. Those are the walls of the ADU, and these make up the majority of the framing. You can't see it on this plan, but the rest of the framing is comprised of the ceiling joists, roof rafters, and roof sheathing. You can also see the gaps in the walls, framing here, that show the locations of the door and window openings. Now, it's important to know that the walls around the outside of the ADU are different than the walls on the interior. These outside walls create the structural strength for the ADU and will be bolted down to the footings, while the interior walls are there just to create separations between rooms. I'll show you more of that once we get into the unit itself. All right, let's head inside the ADU. We're walking through the front door here, and now we're heading into the living room, and you can see the framing is in progress. As I mentioned, the framing includes the walls of the ADU structure, as well as the ceiling joists and the roof rafters. But you can see here that there are some pieces of wood running in a diagonal direction. You can disregard those. They're there just to temporarily create some strength for the ADU while the framing is still in progress and will be removed once all the framing is complete. Now we're walking through the living room and into our kitchen, and you'll notice here you can see the black plumbing waistlines coming out of the bottom of the walls for the sink and the dishwasher. And as we pan back around, you'll notice there's a difference between the exterior walls and the interior walls. The exterior walls all have plywood already nailed to the outside. Those are called shear walls, and we'll talk more about those in a minute. Now, let's take a walk towards the bathroom. You'll see on our left, it's a nice big laundry closet that will house a stackable washer and dryer unit. And now we move into the bathroom. And again, you can see the black plumbing waistlines there for the sink, toilet, and shower. And as we turn the corner, you can see it in the first bedroom. And at the back of the bedroom is where the ADU is attached to the original garage. And now we're in the second bedroom, and you should be able to see it at the far end. They've already framed out the header that will create the opening for the large closet and the closet doors. You'll notice the window in the bedrooms are rather large, and that's because there's a requirement to have what is called egress windows in the bedroom. The building code requires that the opening of a window is large enough for someone to crawl out through in case of a fire or other emergency, and these windows have to be relatively low to the ground to make it easy to get out without needing a chair or a step stool. Now, let's take a look up here. You can get a view of the ceiling joists. Those are running parallel to the floor as well as to the roof rafters that are running up to the ridge beam. The roof rafters will soon be covered by plywood sheeting and will create the base for us to install roofing material. The ceiling joists create a horizontal surface that will carry the weight of the drywall that will be nailed onto them, thus creating the ceiling. Let's talk a little bit more about the exterior walls of the ADU, because they need to be built in a specific way to create the structural integrity for the home. First, you can see that the windows have been framed out with a nice big header at the top. In addition, if we zoom in on the bottom of this wall, you can see that there's a piece of lumber called a sill plate that sits on the top of the foundation footing and is bolted down to the rebar steel that was embedded in the foundation. Also, as mentioned earlier, the outside walls are covered in plywood, which is nailed to the framing of the exterior wall. This creates additional strength and rigidity to the structure to help support the ADU in case of movement from things like earthquake and wind. Now, if you take a look at the interior walls, at the bottom you will notice that they sit on top of a 2x4 that is nailed right into the foundation slab. They aren't bolted down to the footings like the exterior walls are. Here's a view of that shear wall plywood from the outside of the ADU. What's nice about this is it creates a great surface to attach the weather barrier paper as well as the lath wire that is necessary for the stucco. And the stucco will be sprayed to create the exterior surface of this ADU. And here's a view of the roof rafters from the outside, and you can see where they connect to the ridge beam at the top, which is also attached to the rafters on the opposite side. There's also a piece of fascia board installed at the end of these rafters, a foot or so past the exterior wall, and in another few hours, the framers will cover that entire roof area with plywood sheets, just like you see on the outside walls, and we'll be ready to start installing the roof underlayment and shingles that will create the roof. In a few days, all the framing will be done and ready for our city inspection. Now you're ready to move on to the next video in our step-by-step guide, the utility rough-in. Please check out maxablespace.com for all the tools, tips, and design ideas to get you started on your ADU journey. When you're ready, please click the link below, and Maxable can connect you with architects, contractors, and lenders that can turn your ADU goals into reality. Thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe.